Hello students, welcome on Microbiology by Santosh Napte YouTube channel. Now in today's lecture, we will see the topic prokaryotic DNA replication. And in this topic, we will see the basic concepts of DNA replication and then we will see Meselson and Stahs experiment, which experimentally proved that DNA replication is semi-conservative. So before starting further, if you have not subscribed this channel, so kindly subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte so that you will get notified with upcoming videos. So let's start this topic. Now the first slide is here. In this, just we will look at a glance. So what we are going to study in this topic? So in this prokaryotic DNA replication, we will see that is general concepts of DNA replication. Then we will see semi-conservative DNA replication. Then we will see modes of DNA replication. And lastly, we will see about the Meselson and Stahs experiment. So let's start with general concepts of DNA replication. So here in this topic, that is general concepts of DNA replication. So what is meant by DNA replication? So DNA replication, it is the biological process of producing two identical copies or replicas of DNA from the parent DNA molecule. So whatever, just you know, remember that cell division. So what is cell division? Cell division, it is nothing but the formation of daughter cells from the parent cell. So in case of cell division, there is two daughter cells are formed from the original cell or from the parent cell. Same is here, but it is related to DNA. So what is DNA replication then? So DNA replication, it is nothing but the biological process in which there is a formation or production of two identical replicas or copies of the DNA from the original DNA molecule or from the parent DNA molecule. So that is called as DNA replication. So here, that DNA replication, it occurs in all living organisms. DNA replication, it is occurs in all living organisms because it is the most important or essential part of biological inheritance. So whatever that genetic material or that characters get transferred from one generation to next generation, that occurs through the DNA, which act as a genetic material. So that's why this DNA replication, it is a very important biological process which is essential part of the biological inheritance or transmission of characters. So all of you know that DNA, it is made up of two strands here, and that's why it is a double helix of the two complementary strands. And when there is a replication or that DNA replication takes place, at that time that each strands, they get separated from each other, and these each strand of that original DNA molecule, then it act as a template for the formation of new strand. That's why whatever that new daughter DNA molecules will be formed here, they consist of one strand which is old or which is a parental strand, and the another form, it is a new strand. So there is a one strand is old and one strand is new. So that's why this is called as semi-conservative DNA replication. And because of this semi-conservative DNA replication, the new helix which is to be formed, it consists of one original DNA strand as well as one newly synthesized strands. So this is the basic concept here. Then we will see that is these strands. So here, so whatever that new strands will be formed here, they have the one old strand and one new strand. So that's why this type of DNA replication, it is called as semi-conservative DNA replication. So in a cell, that DNA replication, it begins at a specific locations or specific points, and that locations or that points, these are called as origins of replication. So during this replication, there is an unwinding of DNA takes place, that is at origin, and there is a synthesis of new strands takes place, which is occur with the help of that enzyme called as, so there are so many enzymes are involved here, so that is accommodated, or that is the ancillary enzyme that is called as the helicase enzyme, which results in the replication or formation of replication forks, which is a Y-shaped structure here, and which grows bidirectionally to form the new DNA strands or new DNA molecules. So along with this helicase, which is an enzyme, there are number of proteins as well as enzymes are associated with this replication fork, and all these enzymes and proteins, they help in the initiation and continuation of the DNA synthesis. And most prominently, the very important enzyme which is actually involved in the synthesis of new DNA strands, that is called as DNA polymerase. So this DNA polymerase, it synthesizes new strands by addition of nucleotides which are complementary to the another strand or that template strand. And generally, this DNA replication process, it occurs during the S stage of the interphase, that is of the cell cycle. So the next, see, this is the DNA replication process, which is explained in a simple manner. So this is the original DNA molecule here. Yes, I will take the pen. So this is the original DNA molecule here. So this is the original DNA molecule. Now this original DNA molecule, so now it is, there is a two strands are present. Later on, these two strands get separated from each other. So there is the original DNA strands pried apart, or that strands, they get separated from each other. Now this is the one strand, that is actually this is the new strand here, and here this is also the new strand. So these are the separated two strands here. One here, one strand, new strand is here, that is old strand is here, not new, this is the old strand. So this is the old strand, or we can say it as a parental strand. This is the old strand, or it is called as parental strand, and this account, so this is act as a template. So this old strand, they act as a template strands here, according to which there is a synthesis of new strands takes place. So this is the template strand. So according to that, there is a synthesis of new strands. So this is the synthesized new strand, or this is also the new strand. So here there is a synthesis of new strand takes place according to the old strands. So these are the new daughter DNA molecules. So whatever this process is here, that is formation of daughter DNA molecules, in which one strand is parental strand and another strand is newly synthesized strand. So this process or biological process, it is called as DNA replication. So it is known as DNA replication. Okay, so this is about the DNA replication. See, this is the diagram of cell cycle. So where that synthesis, see, these are the different stages in the cell cycle here, and this first stage, which is called as G1, it is a growth phase, this one. Then later on, there is a S phase is here, which is in which, or during which, there is actual DNA synthesis takes place. Then later on, G2 phase is here, that is, it is a growth and preparation for mitosis. And this M phase, or it is also called as mitosis phase here. Okay, this is the diagram of this cell cycle. Now see, next point we will see, that is about the modes of DNA replication. So there are three different modes are there, that is through which the DNA molecule get replicated. That is, there are three modes are there. One is conservative mode, then later on semi-conservative mode, and third one is there dispersive mode. So there are three different types of modes or models of DNA replication. So what is meant by a conservative model or conservative mode of DNA replication? Now see here, this is called as the parent DNA molecule, or it is a parental DNA. Now here, so both of these strands are in blue color. Okay, dark blue you can see here. So in conservative model, so whatever that DNA molecule is here, parental DNA molecule, it is conserved. And whatever that new another daughter DNA molecule is here, it is completely new. That is, both strands in this strands, What if the two daughter DNA molecules are formed here? One is completely old strand or it is completely conserved, and second strand it is completely new strand. So later both of these DNA molecules they get replicated and again two daughter DNA molecules are formed here. So here also this is the old strand which is conserved here and this is the new strand which is completely new. Here also old strand is conserved and that new strand is formed here, that is which is completely new strand. Okay, so in this way, so such type of mode of DNA replication, it is called as conservative mode or conservative model of DNA replication. Second type of or second mode of DNA replication, it is called as semi-conservative model or semi-conservative mode of DNA replication. See again, this is the parental DNA molecule here. It is a parental DNA molecule. Now in this, so what are these two daughter DNA molecules are formed here? This strand, it is old strand or it is a parental strand. Okay, in second DNA also one strand is old strand, so this is the old strand and this second one is the newly synthesized strand. So this is the new strand here, this is also it is a new strand. So in this way, whatever that two daughter DNA molecules are formed by this semi-conservative mode of DNA replication, in that one strand is old and another one is new. So here also, say in second replication also, so whatever that two strands get separated from each other, now this is a old strand here and this is again, so this is the actually old strand for this replication and this is the new. Here one is old, another one is new. So in this case there is a formation of daughter DNA molecules. So such type of DNA replication, it is called as semi-conservative model of DNA replication. And third one is here, dispersive model of DNA replication. So if you see this diagram here, you will see that whatever that two daughter DNA molecules are formed, they will consist of some segments which are of newly synthesized DNA molecule and some fragments or segments which are from old DNA molecules. So then it is called as dispersive model of DNA replication. But this semi-conservative model of DNA replication, it is the most accepted model of DNA replication, and the cells or the DNA present in our cells also, or other living organisms, they replicate through this semi-conservative mode, or they replicate through this semi-conservative model of replication. Okay, so the next slide is here that we will see semi-conservative DNA replication. As I told in previous slide, this semi-conservative DNA replication, so this is the parental DNA molecule. This parental DNA molecules or the strands of this parental DNA molecules, they get separated from each other. So this is the old strand here and this is also the old strand. So whatever that strand, so they act as a template strand. So this is the old strand and it acts as a template. So this is also the old strand and it acts as a template for the another strand. So according to the nucleotides present on this DNA molecule, there is a formation of new strand. So this is called as the old, so this is known as new DNA strand and this is also called as the new DNA strand. So in this DNA molecules, daughter DNA molecules, one strand is old and another strand is new. So that's why such type of DNA replication, it is called as semi-conservative mode of DNA replication. Now here, that is in second replication, so whatever that DNA molecules are formed here, so both of these strands they get separated. So according to this, there is a new strand is formed here and here also. So in this case, both of these strands, they act as a template. So there is again two daughter DNA molecules are formed here. Here also two daughter DNA molecules are formed. So that sequence, that nucleotides or that strand, it get conserved. So one is old and one is newly synthesized. So that's why it is called as semi-conservative mode of DNA replication. So see here, this is the another diagram how that DNA does semi-conservative DNA replication works here. Okay, so here this is the, that strands get separated. There is the involvement of many enzymes, DNA ligase, DNA polymerase, then DNA primase, so helicase, then this single-stranded DNA binding proteins. One is leading strand, another one is lagging strand. But whatever that new DNA molecules are formed, they consist of one old strand, one new strand. Okay. So the next point is Meselson and Staha's experiment to prove that DNA replication is semi-conservative. Now, up to here, we know that there are three different modes of DNA replication, and then we have seen the semi-conservative mode of DNA replication. So, in semi-conservative mode of DNA replication, so whatever that two daughter DNA molecules are formed, in that DNA molecule, one strand is old or parental strand and another strand is newly synthesized strand. So that's why it is called as semi-conservative mode of DNA replication. And to experimentally prove that the DNA replication is semi-conservative, these two scientists, that is Meselson and Staha, they perform one experiment by using that nitrogen isotopes, heavy nitrogen isotopes, and they use the bacteria Escherichia coli. So in these slides, we will see how these Meselson and Staha, they perform that experiment to prove that DNA replication is semi-conservative. So these two scientists, that is Meselson and Staha, they conducted this experiment, that is on DNA replication, by using this Escherichia coli bacteria. And they begin this experiment by growing these E. coli bacteria in a medium or in a nutrient broth which consists of heavy isotope of nitrogen, and that heavy isotope, it is nitrogen 50. So this is the heavy nitrogen or isotope of nitrogen which is used by these Meselson and Staha so to perform this experiment here. And when they grown that E. coli cells in a medium or on a medium which consists of this heavy nitrogen, that is nitrogen 15, then these E. coli bacteria, they took up this nitrogen and they use this nitrogen 15 to synthesize new biological molecules, including this DNA molecule. So they utilizes that heavy nitrogen which is present in that medium, and they synthesizes new biological molecules, including this genetic material, that is DNA molecule. And after many generations, when they grown in this nitrogen 15 medium, so these nitrogenous bases of this newly formed bacteria, these DNA of this bacteria were labeled with this heavy nitrogen, because these bacteria, whatever that new bacteria are formed here, E. coli bacteria are formed, they take that nitrogen 15, and that's why, and they utilizes that nitrogen 15 for the making of DNA molecules. So that's why that bacteria which having these DNA molecules, now they are labeled with heavy nitrogen. And then these bacteria, now they switch to another nutrient medium which consists of a light nitrogen isotope, that is N14 or nitrogen 14. So they shifted to new nutrient medium which consists of light isotope of nitrogen, that is nitrogen 14. And in that, so the DNA after this switching, they would have to made up of nitrogen 14, as this would have been the only nitrogen available for that DNA synthesis, because in newly or in that new nutrient medium, there is only nitrogen 14 is there. So what was expected, whatever that new DNA molecules are formed here, in another, when there is a switching is there, or when that bacterial cells are transferred to that nutrient medium which consists of nitrogen 14. So what expected at that time, whatever that new DNA molecules are formed, they must consist of that only nitrogen, that is N14, but that is not happened. So Meselson Staha, later on they measured the density of that DNA molecules by using a special technique, or which is a centrifugation technique, and that is called as density gradient centrifugation. So this density gradient centrifugation, it separates that molecules, for example DNA, into bands according to their density. So this density gradient centrifugation, it separates that DNA molecules or in the form of bands by spinning them at a high speed in presence of that chemical which is called as cesium chloride. This cesium chloride, it is actually responsible for the formation of density gradient from top to the bottom of that centrifuge tube. Okay, see, this is the one simple diagram of density gradient centrifugation. We can say this is a centrifuge tube here. It is a centrifuge tube, and here there is a that Sesenium chloride, that is CsCl, that Sesenium chloride, it forms the gradient of that density here. So here more density is here and this is the less density. So that's why this is a light isotope of nitrogen, that is N14, and this is the heavy isotope of nitrogen, that is N15. So according to the density, there is a band formation will take place. So that particular DNA molecule which has heavy nitrogen, so they will form bond here towards the bottom, and that DNA molecule which has the light nitrogen, they will form bond towards the upper side of that centrifuge tube. So this is the diagram, simple diagram of that test tube or density gradient centrifugation tube here. So this is the that actual experiment which is performed by Meselson and Starr. So what they or how they perform this experiment here? See, this is the E. coli cultures, that is the Escherichia coli, which is taken in a nutrient broth, we can see here. And initially it consists of that heavy isotope of nitrogen, that is N15. So this is the N15 containing medium and which consists of E. coli cells. Okay, so later on the DNA was extracted from these bacterial cells and it is centrifuged in a density gradient centrifugation containing this Sesenium chloride. So according to the nitrogen present in that DNA molecule, that there is a band formation will take place here. So here the density is more, so that's why these DNA molecules, they have more density and they form the band here. So this is the DNA molecule which consists of heavy nitrogen. Okay, so that's why whatever that DNA molecules are formed here, both of these strands of this DNA molecule, they consist of strands having the nitrogen 15. So this is the, that's why it is a heavy DNA, because whatever that two strands are present here, they consist of nitrogen 15 isotope, that is heavy isotope. So later on continuous growing, then there is a replication cycle 1. So that continuous growing first generation in N14 medium. Now these cells, they are transferred to the new nutrient medium which consists of light isotope of nitrogen. So there is a replication cycle 1, and here there is a that nitrogen 14 is here. So what after the replication or after formation of two daughter DNA molecules, now one strand will be old, one will be new. New means here that strand, it has the nitrogen consisting of nitrogen 14, and old strand, it has nitrogen 15. So that's why there is a this type of band will be formed here. See here, this is the intermediate density. Because why it is intermediate? Because one strand having N15 and another strand having N14. So then later on, again in replication cycle 2, again that DNA molecules get separated. So one will having the N14 and N14, and another DNA will having the N15 and N14. So one will be of light density, this N14, and another one will be of intermediate density. See, this is the light density and it is of intermediate density here. And in replication cycle 3, so again there is a both of these parental DNA molecules, they get replicate, and there is a new DNA molecules will be formed. So here that both strands are, or they have the light nitrogen isotope. Here also they have the light nitrogen isotope, and this strand DNA, it also has the light nitrogen isotope. But here one strand is here which is of intermediate density. So all these three DNA strands, that is this one and this one, they have N14 in their DNA molecules, that's why they have light density. But it consists of one N15, that is heavy isotope, and another light isotope, so that's why it has the intermediate density, and this have light density here. So in this way they perform that experiment, and from this experiment they proved that there is a whatever that new daughter DNA molecules are formed, they consist of one old or parental strand and another one is newly synthesized strand. So this is the another diagram which explains that Michelson and Stas experiment. See, this is the that hypothesis was DNA replicates semi-conservatively. Then method was, in first step they grow that bacteria in heavy medium, that is nitrogen 15 containing medium. So this is the that medium here, and then later on, so sample at 0 minutes, so that DNA molecule will form or form band at the bottom. See here, this is the N15 heavy. So the, in this way, this is the that is centrifugation or density gradient centrifugation. So in this case here, it is a intermediate DNA and this is the light DNA. So sample after 20 minutes, so first generation all will be intermediate DNA, or they will have the intermediate density. Then sample after 40 minutes, so one have the that is light DNA molecule and another DNA molecule has the intermediate density. So there is no heavy density DNA molecule is there. So in this way, so transfer same bacteria to nitrogen 14, that is light medium, bacterial growth continues. Then take samples after 0 minutes, 20 minutes, that is after one round of replication, and after 40 minutes, that is after two rounds of DNA replication. So they will form such type of bands here. And finally, these are the results here. So this is the parental DNA molecule. So here, these parental strands get separated from each other and they form the daughter DNA molecules. And one strand, that is old strand having N15, and another strand, that is new strand having N14. Again, both of these DNA molecules, they get separated from each other and there is a new daughter DNA molecules are formed here. So in this way, so it will has the intermediate density, this will also have the intermediate density, but both of these are of that is nothing but the light density molecules here. So in this way, there is a DNA replication takes place in a semi-conservative mode. So that's why this is the experimental proof which is proved by Michelson and Staha that DNA replication is takes place only with a semi-conservative mode of replication. So that's why there is a conclusion is here. This pattern could only have been observed if each DNA molecule contains a template strand from the parental DNA. Therefore, the DNA replication is a semi-conservative replication. So here we have seen these four points here, basic concepts about DNA replication. Then we have seen that modes of DNA replication. Then we have seen semi-conservative mode of DNA replication. And lastly, we have seen that is about the that Michelson and Stas experiment. So friends, watch this whole video and don't forget to subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte. Thank you.